I'm Stephanie from Math with Miss C, and today I'm going to share with you how to create your own activities in Desmos. I've been using Desmos almost every day in my online classes, and it's really transformed the way that I've been able to hold my classes in this virtual environment. So let's get started. I'm going to go to Desmos.com, and on Desmos.com, I'm going to click on the teacher side. So I'm going to click Browse Activity. In Desmos, they have a bunch of pre-created activities, but you can also customize your own activities. So I really like this function because I can still hold classes as I normally would in person. I can do my checks for understandings. I can see student works as if I were circulating in my classroom, and it allows me to just have more control over what my students are doing and then provide them with better feedback virtually. So we're going to click on Customs under Your Activities, and you'll click on New Activity. When you click into New Activity, you'll see this screen pop up, and you can go ahead and name that activity. This is where I would normally name my lesson. So if I'm in Chapter 2, Lesson 2, and let's say that is my equation unit, let's say we're solving one-step addition subtraction equations. I would go ahead and just label my lesson there. The reason I do that is because I am creating these lessons every single day. I want to make sure my lessons are really clear so I can go back and find them as well. Sometimes I'll also put in the date, so that way if I'm comparing it to my gradebook, I can easily figure out which date that activity was assigned on. So I'll go ahead and do that. I'm going to click it so that anyone with the link can view, because I want to assign this to my student. If I didn't want to assign it and I wanted to keep this activity private and not be able to share it with any other teachers, I would click it only I can view. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and create my activity. And once you see create the activity, you'll see this screen here. There's a lot of information on this page. So I'm going to quickly take you through these. On the left side, these are all buttons. So these are things you can put into your Desmos activity. The note is used for if I want to give instructions to students. So let's say I wanted to tell them, solve this one-step equation and show all your steps. I would put the instruction there. Text input is a student response piece, so if you want students to explain their answer or a longer answer, you can use text input. Math input, you can kind of think of as like a fill in the blank. I use these for students to put in a number answer for me. Multiple choice, again, that is a student input. Text box, also student input. Ordered list is a student input as well. There is a graphing function, and the graphing just allows you to push the graph out to students. So if you want students to read a graph for you, you can use this. Let's just quickly look at this. If you look at it, it only allows you to have that graph open and you can plot a line. If you want students to draw on the graph, you would then need to change it to a sketch, and students can then input a graph for you to look at. I'm going to go ahead and delete that. You also have the sketch function, which is really helpful for showing students work. You can put in a media, which is good if you want to embed a video. Let's say you have a video explanation you want to show students, or if you want to put in a picture of a problem or a picture of a graph table, that is where you would input it. The table is like if you want to put in any points or any sort of data, that is helpful for that. And then the button is also a student response piece as well. So with this one, let's say I want them to just do a sketch solving this equation, and let's say my equation is 5 plus x equals 10. And so then, let's say I'm done with this slide, I'll click preview, and students would then go onto their sketch and answer that question. And so this slide would then be pushed onto my teacher end, so that way I can see their work. And so the sketch is super helpful, especially if you want to make sure your students are on the right track. So this was a really quick run through of how to customize your activities in Desmos. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below and I will try my best to answer them. Have a great day. Bye.